I'm in quarantine right now. I will try to speak English at my best. I speak better Spanish because I'm from Mexico, but I understand the most of people in this chat are in the US. So I'll do my best. Okay, there's a question. Can you tell us about your involvement with Pildora? Well, since I know, since I met Christina, I honestly, before that, didn't know as much about sustainability as I do right now. But then I realized it's more complex than that. And now I want everyone to know the same as I do. Well, sustainability for me right now means a lot. I think it should become a lifestyle. More and more each day and more from the years to come, it should become a lifestyle. We should, if not overnight, we should be more conscious about the decisions we made when we buy clothes. We should read about where are they made or by whom, with what material. And in some scenario between A or B, choose the one that you have more information about. Why do I love the most about acting, Helena? Okay, I like the possibility of playing different characters, different lives, because what we do is play. So sometimes I step in the shoes of someone that decides with a different criteria of mine and reacts different from the way I should or maybe I would take. So it's a very nice exercise of making new worlds of another people's minds. So that's acting for me. Do you think the television industry is addressing sustainability? If so, how? No, I think it isn't getting so much attention as it should. I would like to hear about it more and more. I think we should explain it and implement in our daily lives more and more. Well, Christina is joining us in the chat as well. I would love to be here with her, but no, she is virtually with us. Cesar. Okay, Hansel asked me, how do I research before playing a role? Well, by example, my last role was a lawyer. The team that write the story help us in some points. They did a very interesting job with some of the ways you address the information, the way you talk with a judge or with a police or with someone that you're defending. Sometimes it's my my job, but sometimes I got help from the people that write the stories and the producers that have a certain idea of how they want it to show. A35 Van, do you really enjoy the live we did on Instagram, Pildora? Hey, Christina. We are receiving an invitation to Brazil. I have known Brazil, just a tourist a few years ago, and I like it so much. I think Pildora should have presence. Yes, we should go together. And do you think in Brazil the sustainability in fashion is it's a thing right now, or do you think it should get more interesting? In Mexico, we hear about sustainability in fashion, but not as much as I would love to. I really think it should get more and more light. Yes, of course we should go together. But I know a little of Portuguese. My sister lives in Lisbon. Of course I know it's different, but I understand a little. I wish to speak more. I honestly thought that sustainability it was a simpler theme, but no. I understand now it involves ethical issues with humans, with animals, with our environment, and I like something that Christina use in their YouTube videos. We do not have a planet B, so we should take care of this one. Okay, what advice would I give to aspiring actresses? I think I would advise to be to find a way to shine being themselves, because the world is complete, it's filled with beautiful women, talented women, and men, but you have to find your own amount of everything, and that makes you a unique person. So don't try to be like anyone else or to imitate the style of anyone else, because you have your own amount of everything. So I would recommend to be resilient, of course, because sometimes we get rejected very easily. But it's not personal. Sometimes you have to look like this or have to have certain semblance of that type of person. I don't know. A range of age. So there's a bunch of reasons why you can have a certain role or not. So it's not personal. Of course, it has happened to me that I wanted a certain role in a certain project that I wanted so much, but I realized it's not my type, my age, my nothing, so I shouldn't be there. As much as I was very... como se dice, cuando estás encaprichado con algo. As much as I wanted it, I didn't fit. So it happens in acting industry and in life sometimes. You have to realize when someone is someone or something is for you and when it's not. And if it's not, okay, move on and go on and... better things will come. I received a very good question. It's been difficult to be a successful woman in the male-dominated industry that tolerates machismo culture. Yes. Yes. Yes, it's been difficult. Because sometimes... men don't like successful women. And I worked since I was very little, teenage. And I think that the work from young, I think I saw my relationships in from another way. And it, yes, it became difficult. What do you think about fame and influence and the responsibility that comes with? Well, I think it's a huge responsibility because there's a social commitment. Because all I have, all I can be in my acting career becomes from the public. I depend on people watching the projects I do and the roles I play. So I think I should return in some way. If I recognize myself, I am in a unique, well, of course, all my colleagues and I, we have this platform where whatever we say, it can be listened. So I choose my words very carefully. Of course, you can say something at some point that isn't right for some criterias, but I choose very carefully what I say in public because I have the conscience it's being heard. I try to not give examples. I don't want my own friends or my, I don't have a daughter, but, or son, but when I have, I imagine what kind of example I want them to see. So I choose very carefully what I say. Whenever you express some opinion, someone can be offended. And we should be careful about that. But there's always a way to make a point respectfully. What advice would I give women in Mexico? I think, well, I consider myself not a feminist because I don't think about men and men versus women. I just want women to propose them more and think of them as themselves bigger and brighter and more capable. It not depends of men. Maybe in some years ahead or in the future, it's not like, oh, they haven't let us do anything in these centuries and millennia. No, yes, it has been difficult to thrive for some for women. But I think more and more we should propose ourselves more and encourage our friends, our daughters, to think of as themselves more independent and having a successful life. And a successful life don't necessarily mean be a rich executive of, no. I admire the woman that take care of her children and gives them a future and love and attention. I just want women to propose them, to propose themselves more, and that's it. It's not a war. We complement our men and women complement each other, and that's it. Exactly, we are all humans at the end of the day, and we should stick together and resolve problems together. Okay, Hansel asks, what are some of the changes you have made in your life to become more sustainable? Okay, I wasn't so in touch with sustainable world and sustainable fashion before meeting Christina and Pildora, and she explained me with pears and apples. Well, I don't know if that's translated in English. In Spanish, we say with a very simple idea, explain like if you were a little children. Okay, Christina explained me exactly the world of sustainability, and my wish is to become more and more into it. Now I check the sticker in here of the clothes I buy, And if I have an A or B situation, I choose the one I think it's more kind to nature, to the people is working in the factories. And in a maybe you have heard, if you are not paying for it, someone is. So if it's too cheap to be true, it is too cheap and too good to be true. I don't like to think about these big factories and places where maybe children or people is working in very bad situations to make another people very rich because they can sell very cheap and very fast made stuff. I don't like to think about animal cruelty. And more I have buy different stuff. It hasn't been an overnight change. But we can always be more conscious about our decisions, our purchases, our way of making our wardrobe. Yes, of course, I think the same. Pildora should have presence in Brazil. And if by any chance a sustainable project of designers that lives in Brazil see this video, I think they should get in touch immediately with Pildora or with Cristina Almeida, and in Mexico and in the US. I think it will be very important in the next months and years. I have the faith on this happening. Well, Cesar, for me, I would like to speak more and more of this, so the people that follow my Twitter, my Instagram, or see the projects I do in TV, and if they wonder my lifestyle, they will certainly know that I made some choices in buying some kind of clothes and other don't. Do you understand me? I don't know if I have a project per se, but I want everyone to know what sustainability is and the combination of sustainability with fashion. Wear more and more kindly made clothes, thinking in the environment of the planet, because we only have one. Well, I have a new question. What's the biggest lesson you have learned in your career? As much as hard is to recognize it, I think humility. Because at some point you have so much attention and so much nice compliments, and you think you're the best, but you're not. My ego have been challenged a lot of times. I made a fool of myself a bunch of times, and I realized I survived it. And somehow I'm still here, I'm still alive. My career is finding his way. And I learned that you overcome not everything, but almost everything. So humility, because when I misbehave, something happens. So humility, it's something I would recommend everyone in their own industries or lives, that always think with that, with humility. Okay, what would I do otherwise if not acting? You know, when I was a little girl, the last thing I thought I would do is acting, honestly. Almost anyone knows it because I'm not really an como se dice, extrovertida, an extrovert person. I'm not shy, but I don't wanna call the attention so much. But I like how my life it's been transformed for my career. I like medicine, a lot. I was this close of studying, ¿cómo se dice en inglés? International relationships. I saw myself as a diplomat in another world, in another life. Or maybe in the future, I don't know. But I love my career. I'm very thankful for all that have come with my work. Okay, Cesar asked me, for example, I already own food store, also friends who are clothes designers, the way it could be to promote them and so promote sustainability. Yes, in my particular action possibilities, it would be like that, promoting and speaking about sustainability and my friends. And if someone asks, okay, what are you wearing, from where, who designed it, I would like to speak more and more about, I don't know the proper way to say it, it's not a sustainable designer, but a designer that uses sustainable process. I would like to choose more and more of these items in my wardrobe, in my way of life, more and more each day. I think it's my particular contribution. And I think if we all make little changes in our way of life, we can make a difference. Okay, Mexico City seems to have some amazing stories surrounding sustainability. Thrift stores, it seems to be growing. Do you think thought that businesses struggle to operate in Mexico under the current government? I think all business is struggling right now with the current administration. It's not friendly with the opportunity givers, as I like to see the people that gives works. No, it's not easy right now in Mexico. But speaking of sustainability, I think it needs more attention. It needs to be explained, because I thought it was simpler than that. And now I understand that it's very complex and involves ethicals in all ways, with humans, with animals, and with the planet. Okay, how can people try to connect and overcome this? Right now, all the planets, of course in the US and Europe and Mexico, we have this particular problem called COVID and coronavirus. And as every crisis, I think it shows the worst in human nature and the best. I have seen so many movements of helping your community, of being generous, of being like help each other. I have seen and watched so many movements, but I have also noticed that some abusive persons are making opportunities of the need and the pain of someone else. By example, raising the price of eggs and chicken and that breaks my heart. Having that said, I've observed many movements that unite us, and every crisis have this effect. So I think Mexico and the US can observe these phenomena and stick together. So in crisis, people show their true face. You can find a way to be very, very selfish or very generous. And when the time pass, what we do is what we'll speak of ourselves always. I think with patience and solidarity and generosity, we will overcome. I think it will take time in Mexico and in the US and in Europe. The economic world is very challenging right now for everyone. So I think everywhere in the planet is facing hard times. But when the hard time comes, is when we have to be more and more resilient and more willing to overcome this. When the times are easy, it's the obvious choice. But when things are difficult, it's when we have to be more and more resilient and tough, and we have to see ourselves when this is over, and the process between us and that moment is something that will happen, but we will overcome this. Yes, I'm in my parents' house. I choose to be here because it's a very green place. So it's easier to have a quarantine in here with my dogs and a little terrace and space and green and oxygen. Hopefully, people will become more empathic in every aspect of life. Yes, Cesar, I think the same. I love history, and what I've learned is we have been dealing with horrible stuff since centuries before us, and we have to learn about others have suffered before us, and this will be an example for our children, our grandsons. Maybe we will have the chance to tell them what we did, what we do, what we did in this particular crisis. Today, your dogs will not participate in life? No. One of them, Jagger, is very, very... He likes to be everywhere. He likes to have attention all day. Well, what is your daily routine like in this quarantine? Well, I can't lie, it has been tough, because I think, as most of you, I am used to be very active, and this obligated eternal Sunday, it was fun at first, but it's very difficult. Some advices I would give. I saw it in internet from mental health advisors, is to have scheduled, your hours to have breakfast and lunch and dinner, respect them. You cannot have food all day. Dress. As much as comfortable would be being in pajamas all day and all week long, it gives us a different feeling to get a shower, get dressed, not like very fancy, but it gives you another point of view of your daily routine. Do not take naps, because it will give you problems at night to have a 8-night sleep. And that is a circle. If you don't sleep well, maybe depression gets an easier way. So you have to make a day more similar to another as you can. Ay, qué lindo. 35 van or 35 van. You give me your answer, your question also in Spanish. When will I start recording my new project? Well, I should be there right now, but as everything else, it has been delayed. We don't know exactly where it should be safe to start again. Here in Mexico, it's just the beginning. I think we have one more month of quarantine and phase three. Like, everything is in the fridge. We don't know what exactly would happen. We hope that it's not as worst as we imagined, because we have saw Spain and Italy and some horrible stories happening right now. I'm very proud of the civilian force in Mexico, the civilian society, because the government not necessarily told us to take measures, like few days ago, but people by themselves have decided to get in their houses. And of course, it's a difficult advice to give, because life cannot freeze that easily. People need to work and to have their families fed, and it's not an easy advice, like to go home and do nothing. Whoever can do it. Most of us did it willingly and voluntarily, not because the government told us to. I think that gave us a little chance to have a better scenario. I hope so, but we don't know yet. Do you like Mexico City more than New York City? That's a tough one. Oh, I love New York City. My sister lived there for 2 years. 2 years ago, she was studying in NYU. So I came very often to visit her. It's not fair to compare. No, New York City, I think it's the most magical place in the world. But Mexico City is, for me, a magical place as well. If you haven't been here, you should. And I'm not humble about it, because I'm an excellent tourist guide. I love my city, and I think it has more and more things to offer every day. If you like gastronomic, music, everything you want is in Mexico City. And it can be compared to almost all the cities, major cities I know. It can be compared. You should come. Okay, here in Brazil, TV Globo canceled all recordings and have replaying all soap operas and saving the actors. Yes, the same thing is happening in Mexico. Right now, there was a recording programmed with Televisa, but no, it's now delayed. We don't know for how long, but it's been delayed. Of course, it's the responsible thing to do. As much as I would love to be in action again, well, I live with my parents and my 95-year-old grandma, so I wouldn't take the chances to risk her. Cesar, okay. You know what? That particular project is, I think it's one of the most precious to me. I enjoyed it so much. I made such great friendships. And we work till 1 or 2 a.m. in the morning with horrible cold. And we enjoyed it so much. We were laughing all day with Al Diablo con los Guapos project. What it will mean in English, like, the hell with the handsome people. That's the main title of the project. The hell with the beautiful people. Yeah, something like that. I don't know, I think it gets lost in translation, but that's the meaning. Well, the actor that played the driver is a very good friend of mine. Yeah. The devil with the handsome. Okay, yeah. Okay, what is the next project called? No, in English is something like overcoming the lack of love. Hey, Diablin! Okay, we have Alfredo Diablin is one of my most faithful friends. I am so grateful to have you here, Diablin. Bienvenido, muchas gracias por estar aquí. De verdad, eres un tipazo, te quiero mucho. Me dijo en español that he loves me reti harto. That means a lot. Of course, I will never forget you, my little devil. I love you. Thank you for being here. Yes, Cesar, you can call me Señorita Chiquita. Okay, I noticed you watch it. You know all the little jokes. Unfortunately, here in Brazil, only two novels that you made have passed, Mi Pecado and Abismo de Pasión. In this quarantine, I confess that marathon Amar Sin Ley on YouTube. You should. Amar Sin Ley is one of my personal favorites. I like the taste of I like the style of the project, and it has a very particular social commitment. Not very obvious, but we were trying to people that to know the legal advice is important. Dealing with some problems in life for women, like violence, what can they do to protect themselves? Of course, hand in hand with the dramatic story and the romantic story, but the producers and the directors and the writers and of course the actors, we were trying to print this sense of it's something if you're being a victim of some injustice, there's something you can do. And you should be able to go to the authorities. Of course, there are places where it's more effective than others. Okay, we try to people to not get quiet when they are suffering an injustice. I confess that I saw more because of Roberto and Victoria. Tú sí sabes, Van. Okay, Cesar, thank you. Thank you so much. I can see that you really watch it. Okay, my favorite project. You know, there's a tough question because there are some of them that I really enjoyed and they haven't been with equal success out there. And some of them were a huge success and they didn't have a great time. So it's a tough combination. But the latest, that's called Amar Sin Ley. The story was about some lawyers. I think I enjoyed it very much and it was a huge success. And maybe we will have a third season. Soon. Do you know Brazil, Altair? Yes. Some years ago, I went to Rio and I really loved it. And I think I should return as an adult because I went, I think when I was 16, maybe with my sister. I think I will really enjoy it right now as an adult. And now Christina made a commitment to go with me. And let's see what happens with Pildora over there. Okay, here comes a big one. What about theater acting? Did you like it? We'll do more. Okay, I have participated in a couple of theater projects. One of them, I love it. I will pay to participate in something like this again. it was Hitchcock's story, but made, of course, with the English humor in the Mexican style, of course, very stylish. I enjoyed it so much. It was very classy and very funny and very, very nice. We were three male friends and I, each of us, we were playing three roles. I enjoyed so much. And then I did another theater and I didn't like it at all. And I was very happy to end it. So, yes, I think I should do it more. But I haven't found the proper project. And I have one problem. That I made a lot of TV and it uses a lot of time. And when certain projects come to me, I always say, I cannot do it, I have no time, and I hate it. And I think you really have to dedicate the time that theater needs, as long as the as cinema. I haven't made enough to participate in the projects I would like, in theater and in cinema. Ay, Diablín, eres un rey adorado, te quiero muchísimo. Do you think the wardrobe in TV, cinema, and theater should be more sustainable? Yes, I think the wardrobe in every possible way, it should become more sustainable. Every choices we made when we buy items, it should get more sustainable. For personal uses, for professional uses, I think more and more it could be, it should become more sustainable. Next time, then come to Sao Paulo. It reminds a lot of Mexico City. I love your country. You know something? Some places in Rio also remind me Mexico City. Of course, there are completely different cultures. And everything, but I think they have a similar flavor. But I have to visit Sao Paulo because I have a lot of friends from Brazil, and I like their style. No, Cristina is telling me that it's no, Cristina. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you, Pildora, for making this possible. I feel a little insecure speaking in English, but I did my best. I hope you understand me a little. Thank you for being here. Thank you for listening this this little chat. Thank you for every one of you, especially Cristina, the la mera mera de Pildora. I love you. I love you all. Obrigada, Cristina. See you guys very soon. Bye.
If you enjoyed that video and want to watch it live, head to www.pildoralive.com to get your free membership today and join us in daily live classes surrounding sustainability, mindfulness, and positive environmental impact. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks so much for tuning in. Have a beautiful day. Bye.